So in this video, we will be talking about the Broglie's explanation of Bohr's second postulate of quantization. So what was Bohr's second postulate? That should be our first question. So during studying the Bohr's model of hydrogen, Bohr postulated that the electrons revolve around a fixed orbit. They revolve around a fixed orbit, and these orbits are quantized, that is, under a fixed discrete values, the orbits should have a fixed discrete values, and only then these electrons rotate around them. And also, he also added in the second postulate that they rotate in such a way that they are in a stable state. So this was the postulate, and mathematically, the angular momentum was given as nh upon twice pi. But the question is why? The question is why should a particle, this is a particle, why should a particle rotate in this particular orbit? Now this was explained by de Broglie, and he said that this electrons, while revolving around the nucleus, also possesses wave-like characteristics. So now what he said was, because it has this wave-like characteristics, so it behaves as a standing wave. Now in our wave chapter, when two strings are pulled, if we pull one string, we'll have numerous number of vibrations, but the only vibration that goes on are the standing waves, that is, who has nodes in them. So likewise, by understanding this concept of standing waves, now we have used the concept of standing waves, so if you have any doubt regarding standing waves, please have a look at our chapter of waves. So the standing waves, because we say that only those vibrations can sustain which has nodes, and they in turn behave as a standing wave. So if an electron who has a wave-like characteristics will rotate around a fixed orbit because it behaves like a standing wave. This behaves like a standing wave, and this particular hypothesis is given by 2 pi rn, that is the radius of the orbit, which is equal to n pi. So this should be equal, only then it will have its own specific orbit, that is a integral multiple of the wavelength. So if it's an integral multiple of the wavelength, like we discussed in a standing wave, it will be in a nodes. So if there is a node, then it behaves as a standing wave and it does not require any energy. It is stable at this particular condition. So this was then explained by de Broglie by using this particular hypothesis. And this was actually given by twice pi rn. It's nothing but your nh upon mvn. So this is our whole equation of de Broglie's.